In this lesson, you'll learn about AWS CodeDeploy. So what is CodeDeploy? Well, it's a deployment service that will automate your application deployments. It deploys to EC2 instances, on-premises instances, Lambda functions, and Amazon ECS. You can deploy a nearly unlimited variety of application content, such as your serverless Lambda functions, web and configuration files, executables, packages, scripts, and multimedia files, and of course, much, much more. A CodeDeploy application contains information about what to deploy and how to deploy it. And you need to select your compute platform. It's either going to be EC2 or on-premises, Lambda or Amazon ECS. So let's see what options there are with EC2 and on-premises. So this is where you're deploying to Amazon EC2, of course, or your servers that are actually on-premises, or both at the same time. Traffic is directed using an in-place or a blue-green deployment type. Now, for the exam, you will fully need to understand the various different traffic direction options that are available per deployment type. So in this case, EC2 on-premises, you've got to remember you have the options of in-place or blue-green. So let's see what these two different deployment types look like. Let's say we have an EC2 instance, CodeDeploy, and we send an update, and it's taken the instance out of action, and now the instance is back again, so the code has been deployed. And that's an example of an in-place deployment. So in this case, the actual running instance, the one that's running your code, which potentially could be a production application, has had the code updated while it's actually running. So that means the application is likely to experience downtime. So let's see how a blue-green deployment works. Well, in this case, you might have your live traffic going to target group 1. CodeDeploy is going to actually update target group 2, and then it's going to take out target group 1. Next, we have the AWS Lambda deployment type. This is used to deploy applications that consist of an updated version of a Lambda function. You can manage the way that traffic is shifted to the new version of the application by choosing either a canary, linear, or all at once configuration. So how does this look? Well, let's say we have our function with version 1, and our traffic is going to that function. Then CodeDeploy actually deploys function version 2, and that's our new version of the function. Then traffic is shifted across to it using either the canary, linear, or all at once. And in a moment, I'll cover what those different traffic shifting options actually mean. Next, we have the ECS deployment type. This is used to deploy an ECS containerized application as a task set. CodeDeploy performs a blue-green deployment by installing an updated version of the application as a new replacement task set. CodeDeploy will then reroute the production traffic from the original task set to the new task set. The original task set is then terminated after a successful deployment. We're able to shift the traffic across, again using either a canary, linear, or all at once configuration. And here we can see an example with CodeDeploy and Amazon ECS. So CodeDeploy will coordinate the deployment with Elastic Container Service and the application load balancer. Here comes our new task set, and then our original task set will be removed once a successful traffic shifting and a successful deployment has completed. Now let's have a look into a bit more detail about traffic shifting. So with Lambda, traffic is shifted from one version of a Lambda function to a new version of the same function. With ECS, traffic is shifted from a task set in your ECS service to an updated replacement task set in the same ECS service. With EC2 or on-premises, traffic is shifted from one set of instances in the original environment to a replacement set of instances. Note that all AWS Lambda and ECS deployments are blue-green. An EC2 on-premises deployment can be in-place or blue-green. For Amazon ECS and Lambda, there are three ways traffic can be shifted during a deployment. So firstly, we have canary. So here, traffic is shifted in two increments, and you get to choose from predefined canary options that specify the percentage of traffic that is shifted to ECS or Lambda in the first increment and the interval in minutes before the remaining traffic is shifted in the second increment. Then we have linear. Here, traffic is shifted in equal increments with an equal number of minutes between each increment. and you can choose from predefined linear options that specify the percentage of traffic in each increment and the number of minutes between each increment. And then we have all at once. In this case, all traffic is shifted from the original ECS task set or Lambda function to the updated task set or the new Lambda function version all at once. Now that was a lot of theory, but you really do need to understand this theory for the exam. We're going to do some hands-on, but the theory is essential for this. You absolutely will see questions that test your knowledge of these various different deployment options and the various different traffic shifting options as well.